Why, look! It's the bastard son of the late William Kidd. Still a mere boy, and yet 10 times the demon his father was.
Fancy seeing you here, Kenway. Still looking sleek and mean. Did you steal that costume from a dandy in Havana?
No, sir. I found this on a corpse. One that was walking about and talking shite to my face only moments before.
Huh.
So, what's this I hear about a planned raid on a plantation? Not keeping secrets from me, are you?
Not very well. Every day, schooners packed with sugar sail past, coming from plantations nearby. Most times they stop here, sell off a few crates. There's one man visiting today that'd earn you a fine profit. So if you'd like to rob his plantation, I'll point him out.
I would. Is it a Mr. Beckford that owns this plantation?
That's the man. He owns dozens round these islands. And he's bloody rich.
Just the sort I like to see robbed.
His agent is around here somewhere. Find and follow him, and he'll lead you straight to your prize.
Of your enterprise here, I understand that you are men of discernment. Burford, Manning, to me. We've done with this place.
Aye, sir. What's our course?
We'll return to the plantation and there take stock of our inventory. And there's a good harvest this year.
You might not want to load some. This is anything like a friendly fort, Ken.
Nonsense, man. I had a delightful conversation with a chap just now. We came to quite an understanding.
As you see, sir.
All up and up, well, boys.
The look of a man crafting a bold idea. A look I've seen before.
You mark well, Adam. I've just overheard one of the Beckford's men talking grandly about his plantation and all the cargo he's keeping there, and it gave me the idea that I might take these goods off him and sell them off for a better price than he'd ever ask.
Ah, a man of vision. I like this idea.
Hands up! Let's get moving!
Loose tops and royals!
Sir, to starboard!
Some wrecked cargo here, sir.
Our force patrol these waters closely, Captain.
Hold at it. There's trouble afoot.
I see them.
Reef the mains! Clew up gallants!
As much sail as you can!
Stunsels, let's ride this squall!
Dead ahead, sir!
This man's working for Peter Beckford's people. Do you know them? The Beckfords and their sugar empire.
Aye. The Beckfords and the Draxes. I never worked their plantations, but I knew their names from hearing other men curse them.
But you worked a plantation, no?
A modest one, aye. As a striker in the boiling house.
Boiling house? Was it water they boiled? Something else.
Cane juices. The hard process making sugar. Dangerous. Must be why it fetches such a dear price.
What's it like? Toiling on a plantation day and night.
Well, with the cane sugar cut and harvested, it's run between two metal rollers and crushed the juice from the plant. After collecting the juice, it was time to boil away the waters from the sugar. This we did in Tatches. Let me tell you, brother, boiling sugar is near the hottest thing on earth. Just a touch on the skin will stick like birdlime and burn on, leaving a terrible scar.
Jesus. It's a risk to anchor too close. Soldiers roving the plantation would catch us for sure.
Drop here then and sneak ashore. We'll look after the jackal.
Such disarray!
Bit of a do, sir, that's all. It's Wilmington's birthday.
And you saw fit to get pickled on duty?
It's no bother, sir. We've everything sorted.
We'll soon see, won't we? For you must double the watch this evening.
Double, sir? Whatever for?
I believe I was followed here. By pirates, if my eyes on me. Though the ship was uncommonly large for such rascals. Certainly wasn't slavers, though. Not a ship that size. In any case, double the watch. And keep your damned eyes wide for anything suspicious. You up there! Look alive, man! You've a job to do!
Apologies, sir. I'll keep my eyes peeled.
What is going on here today? How do you suppose you'll be able to ring that alarm if you're piss drunk and barely able to stand?
Forgive me, sir. I am fit and able. If I see any strange... Forgive me, sir. I am fit and able. If I see any strangeness about... You'll hear the bell ringing straight away, I promise.
I'd like to speak to the man in charge here. I require entrance to the warehouse. Which of you dogs has the key to the warehouse, huh? The key, goddammit! Someone find me the key!
Faster, lady. We don't leave till it's done. You can move on. I didn't hire you.
Got to be moved, lads. With gumption. These lads. I'll not have you throw your back. We're not done here, Smith. You can gab later. We're not done here, Smith. You can gab later. Use your knees, lad. Such at Williamsburg under Governor Spotswood. These skirmishes with Powhatan tribesmen rebelling against the enslavement, they're nothing too bloody.
Stop you!
You won't lose us that easily.
Get back here, you deaf turd!
Not worth it.
Georgie will relieve him of more of his burden soon enough, I'll warrant.
Here's to our pirate republic, lads. We're prosperous, and free, and out the reach of kings, clergy, and debt collectors.
Near 500 men now pledge their allegiance to the Brethren of the Coast in Nassau. Not a bad number.
True. Yet we lack sturdy defenses. If the king were to attack the town, he'd trample us.
Then let us find the observatory. If it does what these Templars claim, we'll be unbeatable.
Not that twaddle again, can we? It's a story for schoolboys. I mean, proper defenses. Steal a galleon, shift all the guns to one side. Would make a nice ornament for one of our harbors.
It will not be easy to steal a full Spanish galleon. Have you one in mind?
I do, sir. And I'll show you. She's a fussock, she is. Fat and slow.
The jackdaw and his knives. Pinchner from the Spanish.
Aye. In the midst of a hurricane.
Just before the treasure fleet was smashed against the shore.
Was the haul aboard as rich as men are saying?
A thousand times that. I reckon £1,000,000 worth of reals was sunk that day.
Devil love a hurricane. We'll have a dive there one day. See what we can rummage up.
Diving them wrecks would be a nice change of pace for us. No need for violent actions against Mood.
That's some soft talk coming from a pirate. And as it happens, I mostly agree. We'll save the clashing of cutlasses for the military. And them that get in our way. Easy as she goes. No telling what you may find out here.
Like staring through a waterfall.
Don't soil your breeches, lads. And God bless.
That ship's a monster. Look at the size of her.
Aye. And we'd not last long face to face with her. Hear that, Kenway? Keep your distance. We'll strike when fortune favors us.
Under cover of darkness, most likely.
Aye, it may come to that.
The gallants and royals!
Roll them
mizzen tops!
Charles. Reckless as they come.
An old friend of yours?
Not a man I call a friend. But we've been doing this kind of work for so long, I can't help but respect them. Good news for us.
Sailing for that island.
I know the place. A natural stronghold used by a French captain named Ducasse.
Julian Ducasse, the Templar.
Name's right. Didn't know he had a title.
I know the man. And if he sees my ship, he'll know it from his time in Havana, meaning he may wonder at who's sailing her now. I can't risk that.
And I don't want to lose that galleon. Let's think on't. Maybe wait till it's dark before hopping aboard.